An excellent review article is as equivalent as a nicely written research paper. So if writing research articles wanted to publish them in refereed journals or journals of very high repute, those are involved in quality databases like Scopus, SCI, or want to publish them in unpaid journals, then yes, this video is for you. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel My Research Support. So friends, today we'll be discussing about how to write an excellent review articles. So we'll start with writing title page, then we'll move towards introduction and main content of literature review. This I feel the most important part of this video. So we'll see different techniques to organize the literature review. This may consist of different methods, results, discussions, validations, etc. And then we'll move towards the last part, which is conclusions and references. Prior to start the video, I would like to answer few of your questions. So first important question, how many number of research articles or books I should have if I want to write a review article? So my answer is 5, 10, 20, 50, 100 or even more than that. If you search on the internet, you will find some review articles available. Those are having 100 plus references. Usually scientists used to write these types of reviews, and it is really very difficult to write these reviews. Rather, I can say you can go for research articles with experimentation. This is comparatively simple because you have to invest lot of your time and you have to critically analyze those review papers or references. On other side, you will find some review articles, those are published based on only 5 to 10 research papers. So we can consider my own example. This research article I have published few years before. So interestingly, you will find only 5 to 6 references are there, and based on that I have written this review. So it is this is completely depends on your working area. If you are working in the area where lots of research articles has been available or lots of research has been carried out, then in that case you have to go for considerable amount of research articles or considerable number of research articles. So I will suggest to consider, if you are working in this particular area where lots of research articles are reported or available, then you have to consider 20 to 30 recently published research articles, few quality books, and based on that also you can write a good review. And if you are working in the research area where not many research articles are reported, in that case you can even consider 5 to 10 research articles, few books, if you want to write a good review article. Now the second question, which types of journal publishes review articles and why? So as per my knowledge, around all the journals or even more than 95% journal publishes review articles. And why? Obviously, see, the research articles are published, this is because these research articles are helpful to the society, or if the scientists or researchers are working on the specific problem, then by referring this research article, they will get an idea that what types of methods are used and what results can be expected. Similarly, by referring your single document, those researchers or those scientists will come to know that what has been done by 20 to 25 researchers in a single document. So definitely this is helpful to those scientists, that means this is helpful to the societies, and hence nicely written review articles are considered around in all the journals for publications. Prior to start writing the review articles, you should be familiar with these three important terms: literature survey, literature review, and literature outcomes. So in literature survey, you have to gather and collect some important quality resources, recent publications in some refereed journals or in some good conferences, some good books, periodicals, technical reports, etc. Research article plays an important role in writing review articles. So you have to be very careful while selecting these research articles. So how to identify the research articles those are published in refereed journal? For that I would like to show you a small tutorial. See, here you can search for the research article that you are about to involve in writing your literature review. So you have to search the title related to your topic. So for example, if I need research articles published on this topic, MR fluids development, so I'll just click on it. One thing that you have to do, you have to add this word at the last, Google, last of your search, Google Scholar. So as a result, what will happen, see, the every paper will indicate number of citations received. See, this paper has received only one citation, means only one researcher has included this paper or referred this paper in order to prepare their research articles. So similarly, we can go for these papers. See, this is my own paper. This has received 76 citations, and this is really a good number. So if the citations are more, that means the many researchers have included this paper in their research articles or referred for writing their research articles. So you have to select research article those are having a good number of citations. That does mean these research articles are published in refereed journals. One more parameter that you have to consider is published year. You have to consider around more than 80% research articles, you have to consider recently published, means published in recent 5 to 10 years. In 20%, you can consider few old research articles also. For example, see, you can see this research article which has received citations of 352, and definitely it is really a very high number. So definitely, even though this research article is published in 1994, you can consider this research article in order to write your literature review. You will find many research articles, those are published in 1994, but those research articles still not having the number of citations. So in these two parameters, you have to keep in mind while selecting the research articles for writing your literature review. Next parameter is literature review. So we have to organize and analyze the literature by considering important points and different techniques, and this is the ultimate aim of this video. So in this literature, you have to emphasize on major published works and narrow topics, and then only you will be able to critically analyze the literature. If you are selecting broad topics, then this will become only the repetition of other works, and you won't be able to critically analyze the literature. So we'll discuss this point in detail in next part. Next parameter is literature outcome. So after going through the literature review, you should come up with something, and you should say that I am doing this research because I am addressing a topic that has not been addressed by any researchers. Means you should identify the weaknesses and gaps of the research, and then only you can say this, and you will be able to publish your review articles or considered for publications in reputed journal. So let's start with the title page. Here we will see how to write a title for review article, affiliations, abstract, keywords, and then we'll move towards writing introduction. So friends, as you can see, there are basically four important parameters on title page. So title itself, then you'll find affiliations, authors' names and their institutes. Then third parameter is abstract and keywords. So we'll start from writing an excellent title for review article. So I have taken few snapshots of good titles of review articles. See, I will be having total 5 titles. See, the title is always the first impression of any manuscript. So when we will go for submission of our manuscript in any journal or conference for publication, then if there is a problem in the title of your review article, or there is a mistake with the title of your review article, then your manuscript will be rejected in the preliminary stage. It won't be considered for publication or revisions or further processing. So you have to be very careful while writing the title for your literature review article. So in order to write a very good title, you have to follow 6-point strategy that I am going to discuss. I am already having a video on how to write a research article, and there I have discussed in detail this page, but right now we'll see the few important points or highlight few important points in regards to the review article. First point is method of writing. So you can opt different styles for writing a title for your review article. So we'll consider these examples. See, this is a first example where authors have added this word, a review, at the starting, and then the topic they have selected for writing literature review. So a review of challenges and solutions in the preparation and use of magnetorheological fluids. Similarly, you can add the same word after writing the topic name. See, in the second case, what these authors have done, they have written this word, a review word, at the last of the topic. So in that way also you can write a title. One more way that you can write this word in middle, not necessary in title that you have to use this word, in other ways also you can write the title. See, we'll consider this example. See, a study on properties and selection criteria for magnetorheological fluid components. So in this way, or you can say the comparative study, right? The only thing is your title should reflect that your article is review article. For example, if you consider this example, if I am removing these words, a review of, I am simply writing challenges and solutions in the preparation and use of magnetorheological fluids, then also this title will reflect that this is a review article. See, challenges and solutions, see, these two words indicates that there is a comparison or there is a study among different parameters or comparisons of different challenges and solutions. So in this way also you can write the title. Now we'll move towards second point. Your title should be limited to 8 to 15 words. So friend, there is no any thumb rule that 8 words has to be there or 15 words has to be there, but you can compare different cases. See here, the title is of 14 words. Here you will find 11 words, 13 words, 8 words, right? So the problem is, see, if I am writing very few words, see, I have highlighted these words, for example, preparation and use of magnetorological fluids, these are 6 words. So what happens when the reader will go through this title, preparation and use of magnetorological fluids, then he will not get exact idea that what is there in the literature review. So to be very specific, we have to add few more words. That is the reason challenges and solutions in the preparation, challenges and solutions, these words have been added. So now my title has become specific, and if the words are more than 15, then your title becomes lengthy. So to be very specific and concise, your title should lie in between 8 to 14 words. Third important point, your title should be very relevant to the subject. Obviously, your title is basically a one phrase summary of your literature review article. So to get a perfect idea, your title has to be very relevant and specific to the subject. Next point, it should be in a single phrase. Obviously, we never write titles in the form of sentences, so it should be of a single phrase. Fifth and important point, you should have used correct grammar and proper capitalization, obviously, and to avoid the grammatical mistakes, you can use few softwares like Grammarly. So as we have discussed, to avoid the rejection in the journals or conferences in the preliminary stage, we have to be very careful. Your title should be grammatically correct, and the second point is you should have used proper capitalization. So this is according to the, you have to stick to the author guidelines of that particular journal. So here you can see, in this particular journal, the criteria was your title has to follow the capitalization, and that is the reason that I have used capital letter of each word. And the last point, you have to avoid abbreviations. You never has to use any short forms in the title, or in exceptional cases, if there is a repetition of specific words, then in that case you can use abbreviations. But in 90% cases, you have to avoid abbreviations while writing your title. You have to use a complete word. So in this way, we can write a title for any review article. So now we'll move towards affiliations, writing abstract and keywords. The next part is of affiliations. We know that this is a common part. We just write names of authors just below the title of your review article, and then we write this authors have affiliated to which departments, institutes and organizations. So see, in most of the journals guidelines, we have to write only the names of the authors. We need not to write Mr., Dr., Professor, etc. And we can make use of these superscripts. See, I have written here 1, here 2, and 1 to what indicates? Departments, institute. If both the authors belongs to the same institute, then you have to write the single affiliation. So 1, 2, so 1, 2 indicates this affiliation, and with the help of this star, so what have been written, corresponding author. So I have given my email ID. This indicates that this author is responsible for all communications received from the editorial board, maybe revisions or any other communications. And one important point you have to keep in mind, that if you have contributed a lot in writing this review article, then definitely you have to place your name in the first position. This is because, see, 70% weightage of this manuscript is given to the first author, and 30% weightage is divided among different co-authors. As I am having only one co-author, so 30% weightage will be given to the second co-author. Now we'll discuss abstract. This is again very important part of your manuscript. Reading the abstract itself, the reader will decide whether he will read your manuscript or not. So we'll start with the total words. See, this is my analysis. If you are getting any relevant method or any other method, then also you can prefer that method. So the total words, I have used 131. For this number of words, you have to stick to the journal guidelines, particular journal guidelines. But basically, the number of words used in abstracts are less than 300. So in this journal, the requirement was less than 200. So I have used 131 words. You have to emphasize on these 4 points. See, first point, importance and introduction. See, here you have to write in 1 to 2 lines only the introductory part and importance part. See, you have to emphasize on the application based. See, your selected research topic is basically in recent days used in which types of applications? An introduction. See, performance testing or automatic brakes. This is the introductory part, and this is used for determining stopping distance and deceleration level. So this is the application. So for which applications, current applications, your topic can be used, that you have to write in 1 to 2 sentences, and then you have to move towards second part, which is general methodology. This part is little bit large. You have to write it in 4 to 5 lines. So for that, you have to consider the complete methodology referred by previous researchers. So you have to write down summary of all these researchers in 4 to 5 lines. Means you have to summarize the methodologies used by different researchers. The next part is your contribution, and this is, I feel, really very important part. After summarizing methodologies of previous researchers, what you have done, whether you have compared any results, whether you have compared any methods, and if comparison is made, or then in what forms, in the form of table, in the forms of charts, etc. So simply I have here written that I have done a comparative study of brake testing standards. And then the last part, implications. So whether this research is useful to the society, that will decide this your last sentence. See, what I have written, this study shall help policymakers to draft new policy of these standards. So this is my implication, these are the implications of my research. So accordingly, a key point, a key statement you have to add at the last. In this way, you have to emphasize on these 4 points. And the next part is keywords. You should carefully select the keywords, because your keywords should be easily searchable. That means your document will be easily accessed by any other researchers, and this will definitely help you to increase your citations. So typical keywords used by the researchers are between 4 to 8. Sorry, this is important keywords. After writing title page, we need to write introduction. This is the first part of the main text. So we need to include 1 or 2 introductory paragraphs of the topic that we have selected, and it should be limited to the scope of the literature review. Now we'll move towards an important part, which I can say heart of a literature review, writing and organizing literature. But prior to that, I would like to convey a few important points that you have to emphasize on while writing literature review. First point, major concepts and issues raised. So you have to identify on what major concepts previous researchers have worked on, whether they have tried to improve certain properties, whether they have tried to synthesize something, whether they have tried to solve any problems, or in order to solve these problems, what types of methods they have used, what types of theories they have considered, or they have investigated these theories, or if investigated, then to what degrees they have investigated. So in order to get different results, whether they have used different instruments, so you can compare these results, whether you are getting any deviations in the results, then you can see different applications. So on for which applications this particular research is carried out, so you can compare the applications also. And last, what types of results you have got, whether qualitative or quantitative, you can compare qualitative also. If you have got quantitative results, then you can see the numerical value, you can compare these numerical values also. In this way, you can consider these important points, and in order to maintain proper flow of this literature review articles, you have to consider a few steps. First, to make use of proper citations. If you are referring other works, then definitely you cannot represent it at yours, or if you fail to give proper citation, then it will be considered as plagiarism. Second, to report the status and accomplishments of the previous researchers, means you have to emphasize on all the key points while summarizing the research articles. Third, evaluate weaknesses and identifying gaps of previous research. If you have emphasized on all the key points, then definitely you will be able to identify the gaps of this previous research. And last, your comments. Definitely your comments should reflect with a critical thinking, and then only it will get an advantage in the publication process. Otherwise, this will become just a repetition of other works, and nobody will consider your manuscript for publication. Now we'll see different techniques to organize a literature review with some examples. In this technique, you have to simply group all the references in objectives. References means the research article books that you have referred in order to write this review article. So simply you have to divide your topic into number of objectives. Topic is the research area that you have selected in writing for writing this review article. So objective 1, 2, 3 and 4. And what you have to do is, you have to just club all the references under every objective. Means, see, in order to accomplish objective 1, what methodology reference 1 has used, and in order to accomplish the same objective, what methodology is used by references 2, reference 3, 4 and 5, that you have to write under objective 1. Similarly, you will write under objective 2, 3 and 4. For example, we will consider this topic, that I have to write a review article on synthesis and characterization of a smart materials, a review. So I have divided this into number of objectives. You may be used more than this. So composition of material, or to select base structure of material, methodology used for synthesis, actual synthesis process and characterization. So what I will do now, the methodology used for synthesis by reference 1 will be different. Methodologies used for synthesis by the researchers in reference 2 will be different, reference 3 will be different. So in this way, I have to critically write under every objective, and for that I have to take reference of these points. You have to emphasize on major concepts, methods. We have already discussed these points, theories used, instrumentations, applications for app, for what type of applications this research has been carried out, different results received. And when we'll do this for all these sections or all these objectives, and the last important part that you have to go for is your comments. So while writing your comments, you have to emphasize on these parameters, relationships in between all these major concepts done by all these researchers, methods used by all these researchers. So there has to be a relationship that you have to identify. Weaknesses or gaps, there might be some questions, those remain unanswered. On that also you have to write your comments. Now we'll take one example. These researchers have opted the first technique that we are discussing. Simply what they have done, you can observe here. See, so the main topic is objectives. See, this is the first objective that these researchers have divided their topic into, composition of magnetological fluids. Then they have discussed what these authors have done, right? See, this is style of writing references. There are basically different styles, Vancouver, Harvard, MLA style. Then you have to stick to the journal guidelines, and accordingly you can write. In many cases, we only use reference number in square bracket, and sometimes we write authors' names and published year also. So you have to see the journal requirements where you are going to submit your manuscript. So this is the first objective where all the references have combined in order to accomplish this first objective, what all these authors have contributed. And then second objective, general preparation for magnetological fluids. Then also they have considered all the references. Similarly, you can divide in number of objectives, maybe applications, you can consider applications considered by various researchers. And the last and most important part, which is C, research gaps, status and future trends. So by analyzing the point that we have already discussed, you will be able to write this section, and this section is really very important. And then you may write future challenges also. And then the last part, conclusion. See, conclusion is nothing but you have to summarize this section. You have written this section, research gap, status and future trends. So simple, in 7 to 8 lines, you have to summarize this section, and only key points you have to write there in the conclusions. And there are certain other sections like abbreviations, acknowledgements. So this is again according to the requirements of that particular journal. And the last part is references. So references also, you have to follow the references styles that are mentioned in the journal guidelines. I will mostly prefer you to use this technique for writing your review article, because this is a smart way by using you can write your review article. In this you have to simply group all the references in tables or charts, or you may use any other figure. So what you have to do, you have to just divide this topic into number of parts, part 1, 2, 3, 4 parts, may be more than that. And under every part, you have to organize all the references, maybe in the forms of tables and charts. And after every table or every chart, you have to interpret or you have to justify that table or that chart. So you have to add your comments or you have to analyze these particular tables and charts. So similarly, you have to carry out this analysis for part 1. You can use this for part 2, part 3 and part 4 also. And last, you have to add last section where you have to add summary of relationships of all parts. So here you will write a summary of individual part, individual table or charts, right? And at the last, you have to add the relationships of all parts. For this technique, we will take my own example. I have opted this technique in writing this paper. You can see abstract. After writing introduction, I have written this first part. This is the first part, properties of MR fluids. So I have studied different references, you can see 1 to 3 references, and I organized in a different way, different manner. This will definitely improve reader's ability, and your manuscript will be considered for publications if you are arranging in different types, maybe in tables, in charts, etc. So the properties, MR fluids. So few properties I found in reference 1, few in reference 2 and 3. So similarly, second part, components of MR fluids. See, in this type of chart I have organized. So this is what will add value to your review article. And then you have to just write your comments or your analysis. Then again you can move towards next part, table, then again your analysis, and last you can write down conclusions. This I personally feel the best technique, but you have to little bit spend more time as compared to technique 1. But the chances of publications of this review articles by using technique 2 is better as compared to technique 1. You might write review article by considering both these techniques or combining both these techniques. So take this example. See, this reviewer in this paper, what they have done, they have divided into number of objectives, and in every objective they have used these types of tables to compare different properties, different methods, and then they have written their comments. So you can rather combine technique 1 and technique 2, that will also be better. So what types of tables you have to use, what types of chart you have to use, that you have to think, you have to brainstorm that how you can organize smartly your available data, methods, analysis, results, etc. And then only you will be able to do it. This is third and last technique, and I can say this is a simple technique to apply to make use of chronology. So you have to consider chronology of different events, maybe chronology of years, maybe chronology of countries where the research is carried out. So we'll take one example, considering chronology of years. So you can write your review article in this way also. In these 5 years, for example, from 2005 to 2009, what research is carried out on the area or the topic that you wanted to write a review article, and how? Then in next 5 years, what advancements are done that you can write? Next 5 years, whether any new technology is opted in order to improve certain parameters, or in next 5 years, 2020 to 2024, what are the future challenges, or how smartly we can carry forward the previous research. So in this way you have to organize your manuscript, and in between you have to write your comments also. And when your review article will be published, the reader at a single glance will come to know that how the advancements are carried out on this particular topic. I hope you like this video, so please do not forget to subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon to get latest research updates. So see you in my next video. Bye bye.